What else do you think needs to happen for a Spotify to become profitable in the near future?
Well, if you sit with Daniel Ek, who is the head of Spotify, which I did in Stockholm over the summer, he said if they stopped expanding to new territories, they would be profitable today. Now, okay. I don't look at their books. It's not a public company, okay? But what we have now is we have a war for supremacy. There's only one iTunes. There's only one Amazon. There's only one Google. Who's going to win in the end? Yesterday, RDO, one of Spotify's competitors, dropped a lot of their staff, okay? So they must be hurting. Then we have Deezer, which is big in France and other places in Europe. They're talking about coming to America this fall. We have Jimmy Iovine with a rebranded mog called Beats. So it's just like the cell phone companies now. They laid out a real lot of money trying to be the victor in the end. As far as getting people to subscribe to streaming services, if you talk to Daniel Ek, and it's obvious to those who are in it from the ground floor, the problem is YouTube. Warner didn't want us to make a deal for Spotify in America. And in the window that it took for them to agree, YouTube took hold. So Spotify's competition, Daniel Ek literally says this, and I agree with it, is not Jimmy Iovine, it's not Deezer, it's YouTube. So getting people to pay is a hurdle because of that. There's also been a very bad sales job, and they have terrible publicity at Spotify, and I've told them a million times. People do not understand that a few thousand tracks via playlist, if you are a premium subscriber, sync to your handset. So there are no streaming charges, just like owning them. As long as your iPhone or whatever device, as long as it has juice, you can get music. So when people finally realize this, this will help an increase in subscribers. Now, obviously, the more subscribers, the higher the payouts, both in terms of when someone's a subscriber, a play actually generates more cash. But it's a thorny problem to get everybody to subscribe. But the real problem is YouTube was there first.